You could pass by this spot on Benson Drive in Greenville County and not think about flooding. But underneath flows Little Creek, which can become a big creek in a flood situation. There can be a lot of water in a hurry.
We did some analysis and it showed us that the drainage area to this spot had flood risk. And so there's flood risk for houses and personal property. So what we're doing is just adding more information in that can be shared with the bridges and road managers.
Information gathered by Clemson professor Christopher Post and others involved with the Intelligent River Project. The project places these, basically radar in a box, on the sides of bridges. The goal is to get 125 of these bridge boxes installed by the end of the year in the Upper Savannah and Saluda watersheds.
This is really funded by and working directly with the South Carolina Office of Resilience. So they have a long-standing goal to increase the density of gauges.
The need is great. There are 30,000 miles of streams and rivers in South Carolina.
During a flood situation, the sensor uploads information to a cloud-based system that gives instant information to whoever needs it.
That's important to the state. The SOR gave $300,000 to the project. That buys a lot of sensors. Dr. Post is excited.
It's something we can quickly deploy because we can just glue it to the side of bridges and get data for a lot of locations.
Some of the sensors were placed before Hurricane Helene. Even though one got knocked from its bridge, it kept transmitting data during the storm.
We never found it, but it kept reporting.
A real-life test for a life-saving tool.
The box was developed by Dr. Post and Intelligent River head engineer Syed Oveas. Each box has a battery life of 2 years. The bridge box has other uses too. It can measure tides on the coast, and it can be placed on dams and reservoirs.